Hey guys, Xbox Games here. Check it out. We are back with another quick LEGO set review. This time, of course, it is going to be kit number 75083. It is the ATDP. That's around, I think it's like 500 pieces. And here's the thing. I lost my audio on this, guys. So if things are out of sync here, you kind of know what's going on. If you guys do remember, we did do the ATST right before this. It was a little bit newer of a set. And I believe this kit, 75083, I think this came out in 2014. Somewhere right there, it did come with four minifigures, as you guys can see, kind of just the run-of-the-mill minifigures, but still, I think this particular kit is not probably up to speed, or it doesn't look as cool or as iconic as, of course, the AT-ST, and I'll just pull that up right here so you guys can see it. So, again, I think when this one came out, this was like, I think it was about 70 bucks or so, somewhere right in there. I know you can probably pick them for about 80 or 90 now from what we see on eBay and things like that. You can see, again, it does come with the four minifigures, kind of the three classic troopers. And if I pull up the first one here, this is kind of your classic trooper that we see. And one of the things I like about it, though, is I really like the design on them. The faces aren't all that great, but the helmets kind of had that unique kind of print on them. So I thought that was kind of cool. But you can see, again, the faces, yeah, not too fond with the faces. You do get two of those ones, so they kind of are the same thing. Then, of course, you have this other kind of stormtrooper here. I do love the mask on this one. Again, I love the classic look on the masks. They are great. Then, of course, you kind of have the, whatever you want to call it, the pilot or the person. And again, just the look of the older minifigures, like the helmet on them, is awesome. I think it's definitely better than some of the newer minifigures. They came with the AT-ST. But now let's get right into actually looking at the AT-DP itself. I mean, just look at it. It's huge. And this thing, you can just stomp. Look at this. So you could stomp it right there if you want to. But again, I think it looks cool. I think visually it is not as recognizable as the AT-ST that we did earlier. But still, I mean, the legs, you kind of look at it and say, well, I kind of know what it is. And it does have a little bit of kind of head action movement there. You can see in the back, it does not have the kind of little twisty like the later set does. You just kind of got to move it with your hand. And it has about, I don't know, 60 degrees of kind of back and forth as to where the AT-ST, right, can just completely go around. Now, one of the things you'll see here is that kind of front cannon, right? I would assume that has more firepower than, you know, kind of the other AT series that we see. And it does have a lot of up and down movement. So you could really kind of angle this thing quite often, right? I mean, you can angle it, I mean, quite aggressively. It does have some kind of these little bubbles on the side. I'm not sure what they're used for, if they're kind of like a radar or some type of deflection device. I'm not quite sure. So if you guys know what it is, leave it in the comments. The legs, of course, you guys already know here, the legs don't have much articulation. They are not going to move because the thing is so top heavy. Really, you can't move it from other than this particular position because it's going to tip over, right? So the legs, yeah, keep them static. You see, I'm trying to move it there, but yeah, they just ain't moving anywhere. Now up top, we do have kind of the classic little, you know, little entryway into the top here. I'm going to show in a second, and that's just like, you know, all the other ones. You kind of have, again, there's a little classic top where they poke their head out and look, but then you're going to need access to get inside so you can put your little minifigures inside. So you have kind of this front part that flips up. And you can see inside there, pretty detailed, and it can hold two minifigures. You have kind of them white seats, so I'll flip it around here. And then I have the kind of the red dashboards or the red kind of heads-up displays. They aren't as detailed as some of the newer sets, so sometimes when you look at it, you're probably kind of confused a little bit, like, what is that? What, you know, what's going on with that? But overall, I think it's a pretty cool set. I mean, it's definitely a must-have if you're a big AT dash, you know, whatever it is, collector, because it's just one that fits into the series. Now, let me know what you guys think. I mean, leave it in the comments. I don't see many people doing this one, or if they have, it's a long time ago, of course, because it's a set that came out, what, like 5-6 years ago. You guys, definitely subscribe if you guys haven't already. We do a bunch of giveaways, plus we do have our 15,000 sub giveaway. I mean, really, all you got to do is just sub and basically just hit the bell icon so we know things are coming out. Thanks again, guys.